You can take my word for that, but you don't have to. We have a video. We have a video highlighting and featuring some of the people at Fox News Channel whose lives have been changed for the better by Roger Ailes. Let's take a look.
I think in Roger's case, he is the antithesis of the corporate CEO. And I think his success is distinctly because he is
more of a teacher, really, than anything. He teaches people to believe in themselves, and once they have that, they can really achieve anything.
I started to really admire the presentation. Even if he was yelling at me, you know, sometimes, of course, that happens. And he's desperately wrong when he does that, but it happens.
He just has this clarity that I've never really seen before. He looks through a situation, he can solve the problem, and I think that's his real gift.
He can manage to the bottom line, he can manage in whatever way the company needs something managed. Plus the ability to produce, plus the ability to inspire, plus the ability to create shows, and I've never seen it all in one person, except for Roger Ailes.
He has a great sense of humor. He's not afraid to be in your face and a little irreverent, maybe a lot irreverent.
And he's a little unpredictable, which is what makes him kind of fun.
You learn about honor and loyalty and leadership, not on days when the ratings are terrific and everybody's smiling, but on the days when things that are off camera are beyond difficult.
We went after the Red Cross after 9/11. We did all this child protection stuff where we challenged governors and told people they were villains if they didn't do the right thing. This guy's phone, Roger's phone, was ringing off the hook. He could have easily folded. He didn't. And that's what leads to great success, believing in your people and standing by them in times of crisis.
About 2 o'clock in the morning, phone rings, and he says, Shep, he said, I'm worried about you. Roger Ailes, the CEO of this network, stayed in his office the entire night that Hurricane Katrina was moving in toward New Orleans. He's worried about his people. That's how Roger rolls.
I see how he has stood by me. I don't hide the fact that I have multiple sclerosis. He asked me, well, what do the doctors tell you? And I said, well, they say I might end up in a wheelchair. And he said, okay, then we'll build a ramp to your set. But what he meant was, look, you've got this thing. It's a bitch. It ain't fun. But I don't judge you by that.
Beneath somewhat sometimes gruff and irascible exterior is an extremely tender-hearted man. And I'll never forget Roger's friendship to me when my son died. Nobody reached out more immediately and more fully than Roger Ailes. I mean, he came down here, he hung around, you know, and Roger, you know, he's got a bad ankle, and he was climbing the stairs to my apartment. I mean, he was a total soldier, and I will never forget it.
There's that old expression that you don't really know who your friends are until you're in a crisis. I think that's really true. I found that out last year when my son needed a liver transplant. Peter was really sick, and I had days where I just didn't know how much time I had left with him. And so I really tried to make every day count. And I remember telling Roger about that. And I just knew that he understood. You know, I still am so emotional about it. Because it's only when you're really down in the depths like that that you find out what people are made of. And what I found out in those moments is that Roger is like the real stuff.
My life was on the line over there, and so was Olaf's. And Roger was there to help. I didn't know all that he was doing. I was hoping he was doing all he could, and indeed he was. He wasn't going to give up until the job was done, until we were free and safe. And when Roger puts his mind behind something, it usually gets done. I was the beneficiary of that, and so was Olaf. And, you know, we'll be eternally grateful.
What this man is doing is protecting our freedoms and playing the news straight. And everyone didn't like it. And there are plenty of people who live around me in the concrete canyons in this city who will see you on the streets, give you an evil eye and cock their head at you. You work at that place. And I'm happy to say I did.
He believed that there was a tilt and a slant in the news. And Roger decided that he would like to see journalists exercise their freedom of speech in a more balanced way. And, of course, it offends a lot of people who think that doing it their way is the proper exercise of our First Amendment rights. He's exercising his. Effect.
Roger, despite all of his success, I think has never lost touch with that common sense of every man.
That's Roger's greatest strength. He never forgot, and he never forgets the little pipe.